What if I told you that the innocent QR code you just scanned for a restaurant menu could be stealing your login credentials right now? And what if I told you that by simply pointing your phone's camera at that code, attackers now have access to your social media accounts, email, and personal information? But here's the most terrifying part. QR codes are everywhere, on posters, business cards, restaurant tables, and parking meters. And there's absolutely no way to tell a malicious one from a legitimate one just by looking at it. Welcome back to Tech Sky. Today, we're exposing the emerging threat of QR code phishing, also known as Quishing, a sophisticated attack method that exploits our trust in these seemingly harmless black and white squares. More importantly, you'll learn how to protect yourself from these invisible digital traps that are becoming increasingly common in our QR code-dependent world. But before we begin, I need to make something absolutely clear. Everything demonstrated in this video is strictly for educational purposes only. The knowledge you're about to gain comes with significant responsibility. Understanding QR code phishing techniques is crucial for cybersecurity professionals and individuals who need to recognize these emerging threats. But using these methods to target actual people is not only unethical, but illegal in most jurisdictions worldwide. All our demonstrations today will be performed using our own testing environments and QR codes. We will not be targeting any real users or attempting to steal actual credentials. QR code phishing attacks can cause severe financial and personal harm to victims. The techniques shown today are increasingly being used by attackers to bypass traditional security awareness training, since many people don't think twice about scanning QR codes. And that brings us to the core question. What exactly is QR phishing? QR code phishing, or Quishing, represents a dangerous evolution in social engineering attacks. Unlike traditional phishing that relies on suspicious emails or obvious fake websites, QR codes exploit our implicit trust in what appears to be a simple, harmless image. The beauty of QR codes from an attacker's perspective is their opacity. When you see a QR code, you have no way of knowing where it will take you until after you've already scanned it. This creates a perfect opportunity for deception. QR codes have become ubiquitous in our daily lives. This widespread adoption has created countless opportunities for attackers to slip malicious QR codes into legitimate contexts. What makes QR code phishing particularly effective is the speed and convenience factor. People scan QR codes quickly without thinking, especially in familiar environments. This bypasses the natural skepticism that might be triggered by a suspicious email or text message. The attack method is simple but effective. Attackers create QR codes that direct victims to fake websites designed to steal credentials, install malware, or gather personal information. These malicious codes can be printed on stickers and placed over legitimate QR codes, distributed through social media, or included in seemingly innocent marketing materials. Today, I'll demonstrate exactly how these attacks are constructed and deployed, showing you the tools attackers use and the sophisticated techniques that make these attacks so dangerous. But more importantly, I'll also show you the defenses, how to recognize, avoid, and protect yourself from falling victim to these attacks. Let's start by preparing our Kali Linux environment. Open your terminal and run sudo apt update to refresh our package lists and check for the latest software information. After that completes, run sudo apt upgrade to install any available system updates. When prompted, type Y to continue. This ensures our system has the latest security patches and software versions. Now we need to install our QR code phishing tool. Open your web browser and navigate to github.com. In GitHub's search bar, type Medusa Phisher and press Enter. You'll see a repository that serves as our demonstration tool for QR code phishing attacks. Open the repository and take a moment to scroll through the documentation. You can read about the tool's features and installation process for different distributions. To clone this repository, copy the repository link either from the code button or directly from the address bar. Return to your terminal and type git clone followed by pasting the copied link. Press Enter to begin cloning the repository. After cloning completes, type ls to confirm the Medusa Fisher folder has been created. Navigate into the repository by typing cd Medusa Fisher. Type ls and press Enter to see the contents. You'll notice several important files, including setup.sh, our setup script, and the main Medusa Fisher script. Before we can run the setup script, we need to make it executable. Type chmod plus xsetup.sh and press Enter. The chmod command modifies file permissions, and plus x makes the file executable. This is a security feature in Linux that prevents scripts from running without explicit permission. Now run the setup script by typing .setup.sh and pressing Enter. The system will prompt for your Kali Linux password. Enter it and press Enter. The script will install important packages needed to run the tool properly. After the setup completes, we need to make the main script executable as well. Type chmod plus x Medusa Fisher and press Enter. We're using the same chmod command here because the main script also needs executable permissions to run properly. Before launching the tool, we need to generate SSH keys for the tunneling service. Type SSH key gen, TRSA, B4096, C, followed by any example email address and press Enter. The SSH key gen command creates cryptographic key pairs used for secure authentication with remote services. The TRSA specifies the encryption algorithm, B4096 sets the key length for better security, and C adds a comment with your email for identification. Press Enter through the prompts to accept the default settings and complete the key generation process. These keys will be used to establish secure tunnels for making our phishing site accessible over the internet. Now we're ready to launch Medusa Fisher. Type ./MedusaFisher and press Enter. The tool opens with a menu showing numerous options, which are actually templates for different phishing sites targeting various popular services. For our demonstration, let's target Instagram. Type 1 and press Enter to select the Instagram template. The tool now asks for our tunneling service. We'll use localhost.run for this demonstration. Press 1 and Enter to select this option. Next, it prompts for a port number. Port 5555 is the default. If no other service is using this port, you can accept it by typing Y and pressing Enter. A new window opens for localhost.run. This is where we'll use the SSH keys we generated earlier. For first-time connections, type Yes when prompted to continue the connection and press Enter. You'll see that our phishing page is now hosted and accessible over the internet. Don't close this window as it's maintaining the tunnel that forwards our local server to an internet-accessible address. The tool provides two crucial elements. First, a direct link to the phishing site, and second, most importantly for QR code phishing, a QR code that contains this link. The QR code displayed in the terminal is the key component of our attack. Let's capture this QR code for testing purposes. Press Shift plus Print Screen on your keyboard to take a screenshot. Select the area containing the QR code carefully. Name the file qr.png and click the Save button. The QR code image is now saved and ready for testing. Navigate to your file manager to confirm the QR code image was saved successfully. Now let's test the QR code to verify it works properly. Open a web browser and search for QR Reader to find an online QR code scanning service. Click on the first available QR Reader website. Scroll down to find the option to upload a QR image file. Navigate to where you saved qr.png, select it, and upload it to the scanner. The website should successfully scan the QR code and display the embedded URL. Copy this link to verify it matches our phishing site. Open a new browser tab, paste the link, and press Enter. You should see the fake Instagram login page load successfully. Return to your Medusa Fisher terminal to monitor the attack in real time. You should see log entries showing that someone has accessed the phishing site. Back in the browser with the fake Instagram page, let's test the credential harvesting functionality. Enter test credentials, I'll use TechSky as the username and subscribe as the password. Click the login button to submit the credentials. Notice that after submitting, you're redirected to the real Instagram website. This redirection technique helps maintain the illusion and reduces suspicion, though the interface differences might be noticeable since this tool uses older templates. Return to the Medusa Fisher terminal. You should now see the captured credentials displayed in real time, showing exactly what we entered on the fake site. The tool automatically saves all captured credentials to files for later analysis and use. Let's examine how the captured data is stored. Open your file manager and navigate to the Medusa Fisher folder. Open the site's directory, then navigate to the specific site template you used, in our case, Instagram. You'll see several files here, including interface files that you could modify if you have coding knowledge to update the appearance and make it more convincing. Most importantly, look for the saved credentials file. Open the saved.usernames.txt file to see the credentials we captured during our test. The file clearly shows the username and password we entered. Medusa Fisher includes additional features worth noting. If you return to the main menu and enter number 33, you can access the custom login page creation option. This feature allows you to provide information about a specific site and creates a basic login page tailored to your requirements, giving attackers flexibility in targeting specific organizations or services. Understanding how QR code phishing works is crucial for protecting yourself from these attacks. Here are essential defense strategies. Always be cautious about scanning QR codes from unknown or untrusted sources. Just as you wouldn't click suspicious links in emails, apply the same skepticism to QR codes. Before entering any sensitive information after scanning a QR code, carefully examine the URL you've been directed to. Look for suspicious domains, misspellings, or URLs that don't match the organization you expected. Be especially wary of QR codes found in public places, on unsolicited materials, or in unexpected locations. Attackers often place malicious QR code stickers over legitimate ones. Use QR code scanner apps that preview URLs before opening them. Many smartphone cameras now show a preview of where a QR code will take you before you visit the site. Never enter login credentials or personal information on websites reached through QR codes unless you're absolutely certain of their legitimacy. When in doubt, navigate to the official website manually. For businesses and organizations, implement QR code verification systems and educate employees about QR code security risks. Consider using branded QR codes that are harder to replicate. Keep your devices updated with the latest security patches, as some QR code attacks exploit vulnerabilities in mobile operating systems or applications. Be particularly cautious of QR codes that request immediate action or claim urgent situations requiring your personal information. Today, we've explored the emerging threat of QR code phishing and seen how these seemingly innocent squares can become powerful tools for credential theft and social engineering attacks. What makes QR code phishing particularly dangerous is its exploitation of convenience and trust. In our rush to quickly access information or services, we often scan codes without considering where they might lead us. The techniques we've demonstrated today represent the same methods being used by attackers worldwide to target unsuspecting victims in restaurants, parking lots, retail stores, and countless other locations where QR codes have become commonplace. Remember, the knowledge shared in this video is meant to help you understand these threats and protect against them, never to cause harm. Using these techniques against real people is illegal and can result in serious criminal charges. If you found this demonstration valuable for your cybersecurity awareness, smash that like button right now. Understanding these emerging attack methods is crucial for protecting yourself in our increasingly QR code dependent world. Hit subscribe and turn on notifications so you never miss our latest security insights and protection strategies. We're constantly analyzing new attack techniques and developing defenses against emerging threats. Consider becoming a channel member by clicking the join button below. Share this video with friends, family, and colleagues who regularly use QR codes. The more people understand these risks, the safer our digital environment becomes. Drop a comment sharing your thoughts on QR code security, or telling us about any suspicious QR codes you've encountered. Your experiences help educate the entire community about real-world threats. Remember, in our connected world, convenience should never come at the cost of security awareness. Until next time, stay curious, stay cautious, and keep learning. This is Tech Sky, signing off.